Part 2, An Introduction to the Functionality of Electronic Books.
I now have several options for the book. I can read it online, download it, or print off a portion of it. In relation to downloading, different suppliers have different terms and conditions for this. I can see for this book that I can download the entire book for one day, after which time the download will disappear. I must then download it again if I want to virtually check it out for another day. Just like physical books, the library may have access to one or multiple copies of a particular ebook. It will be noted on the record, as is the case here.
As well as downloading the entire book on a day-by-day basis, this title is giving me the option to permanently download up to 76 pages, i.e. this download will not expire.
As a final word on downloading, you will need software such as Adobe Digital Editions to read the ebook. If you do not have this on your device, you will be asked if you would like to download and install it when you attempt to download the book. The book will also give you the option to simply read it online. Ebooks often look very like their print counterparts and are pleasant to read on screen. A particularly handy feature of an ebook is the ability to search the book for keywords. For example, I can search this book for the word cat, and the search function will tell me that there are 6 results for this word, as well as showing me the chapter where it is to be found and allowing me to click into the page where I will find the word highlighted. Along the toolbar, there are other options for this book. You can, for example, highlight sections, add sticky notes, and add it to your bookshelf. That is your ebook provider's bookshelf, not your University of Galway bookshelf. So now you know how to find and access an ebook via the University of Galway library, as well as manipulate the functionality. If you need any further assistance, do get in touch. You can email us at academicskills@universityofgalway.ie.